About the cars, it looks like the people are complaining about the actual cards and not the decision. It was a little bit, it was too far in between the rounds for Cuadras. They didn't really give them any rounds.
No, that's not right. The fight was much closer now. I thought it should have been probably 7-5, you know what I mean? 7-5, 8-4, something like that. But he won rounds, and he came on good late in the fight. You know, a lot of times people kind of see what they want to see. And it's hard for people to be in boxing and hear all the hype and not pay attention to it. So it's like a lot of times people are influenced by what they think is supposed to happen. And a lot of people, because we think Chocolatito is supposed to beat him, we think anything close, we just give it to him because we assume he's supposed to win it. And that happens with a lot of fighters. Not saying that Chocolatito did win the fight, because he won the fight, I think, but it was a lot closer than probably it gets scored sometimes.
What does this performance reveal from Chocolatito? Is he as good as he is, or is Cuadras just that good as well?
Yeah, Cuadras is just that good as well. Chocolatito is good, but Cuadras is good too. So the problem is going to be when you move up the fight, the Japanese guy is bigger. That's what's going to pose a problem. I'm going to see, can he really take a punch and how well he takes a punch. Plus, what you also saw tonight is that later in the fight, he's a comeback fighter, but he's beat up pretty bad because he's been through a lot. Cuadras hasn't been through that much, so Cuadras' face didn't swell up like he is. And that shows you the effects of a lot of tough fights on fighters.
This was a dual telecast. How do you feel about Gennady Golovkin's performance? A lot of people feel that he didn't look too good, I mean.
Well, a lot of people thought that he would blow Brook out, but I never thought he'd blow Brook out. And because Brook is a smaller guy in weight class, but Brook is a really good fighter. So I knew when Brook took the fight that Brook was coming to win and that Triple G was going to change Brook's mind. He did a good job of changing his mind, but I mean, Brook showed that he can be beat too.
What do you think of the stoppage? A lot of people had trouble with the stoppage. Some people think the corner was protecting him. Some people think he's
going to
continue.
You're talking about Carol Brook's stoppage was perfect. And the reason it was perfect is because the round before that, a person that knows boxing, like myself, knew that Brook was kind of fading away. Why, if he moved up two weight classes to challenge a monster that most people in his weight class don't want to fight, why would you let that monster completely destroy him when you don't have to? As soon as you see it's not going his way, stop it. Don't let him get beat up too bad. Look, he had balls to step up and go take that challenge. We're mad now because other fighters close to the weight class won't fight him. So why are we going to get mad at the stoppers? Because they protect their guy who took it on the chin to go up and fight this beast. Triple G is a beast. We got guys in the middleweight division that don't want him. And this guy's a welterweight and took him. So because his corner stopped it to save him, because they saw that he was starting to dwindle and that pressure Triple G was putting on him was getting to him because Triple G is a big dude. I mean, come on, man.
You were the number one pound-for-pound fighter of the last 25 years. Who do you consider to be, honestly, no bias, no HBO Showtime bias, who is the number one pound-for-pound fighter right now?
Andre Ward, by far. Andre Ward, second is, not to me now, second to me is Vasiliy Lomachenko.
It looks like Brook managed to rattle Golovkin. What would Canelo do to Golovkin in the
ring? I don't know. He won't get in the ring with him. He can't do nothing until he get in the ring with him.
You think he'll be in a rush now to get in the ring with him?
You knew Arguello like you know Gonzalez now.
Yeah.
Who's the greatest fighter from Nicaragua? Is it Arguello?
Well, I mean, you can't take away from one because, let me say it like this. People get all that confused because it's a matter of opinion, but it's like, what if I like myself? If it wasn't for Muhammad Ali, Sugar Ray Leonard, Sugar Ray Robinson, Roberto Duran, Wilfred Benitez, Tommy Hearns, Marvin Hagler, all those guys, I ain't got nothing to draw from to make Roy Jones dreams. So yeah, I want to say maybe I am a little bit of a mix of all of them, but it's hard to just say, oh, you better than those guys because without them, you couldn't make yourself. So without Aguero, we wouldn't be seeing Chocolatito. So it's almost not better to say he's better than Aguero, but he should be a little bit better than Aguero because Aguero put everything he had into him. And with the things that he learned on his own and the new technology and watching the other great fighters, he should have gotten better than Aguero. If he's not, there's something wrong. I mean, do they make 1969 Corvettes and are the Corvettes of 69 better than the Corvettes of 16? No, they're not. They got to get better with time. If you don't, you're doing something wrong.
Roy, how does Triple G cement his legacy now? Because nobody wants to fight him.
I don't know yet. What you saying now?
You loved Barrera, too. He was a great little man, just like Gonzalez.
Yes, I did.
Is Roman just as good as Barrera, or do you think he might have even be superior?
It's close now. It's a very close race. It's a very close race.
So what does Triple G do to build his legacy? Because if nobody wants to fight him, how do you become the best?
No. There are people that want to fight him. See, this is what Triple G got to do. What you got to do is sometimes when the guys got down won't fight you, you got to go up and fight them. You know what I'm saying? And you know, I ain't saying something I won't do. You feel me? When the guy's down, wouldn't fight you, you go up and fight him. You got to go find war. It's there, you just got to go find it. So if you ain't getting no fights in middleweight and super middleweight, then damn it, do like Cal Brook did you. Take your clothes off, go make 175 and take one on Kovalev on war. That's how you get the job done. If you really want to get it done, don't ask me, because I'll tell you the truth about it. I'll be a boxing preacher. I will call them all.
How will war Kovalev play out?
That's going to be a good fight.
How will play out?
So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Secback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Secback. And you can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Secback.